Welcome to an animation of the graph of the cosine function. The goal of the video is to illustrate the graph of the cosine function using the unit circle. So here's the unit circle. Remember, it's a circle with radius 1. Remember that the cosine function is equal to the x-coordinate of the point where the terminal side of the angle would intersect the unit circle. So as we animate this point on the unit circle on the right, we'll be plotting the points where the x-coordinate represents the angle, and the y-coordinate would be the value of the cosine function, which again is equal to the x-coordinate of the point on the unit circle. So at 0 degrees, this is the point 1, 0. So cosine 0 degrees is equal to 1, so we're plotting this point right here. So we start to rotate counterclockwise around the unit circle. We can see that the x-coordinate of this point represents the value of the cosine for any specific angle on the right. So at 90 degrees, this would be the point 0, 1, and since the x-coordinate is 0, the cosine of 90 degrees is equal to 0, or the cosine of pi over 2 radians is equal to 0. As we reach 180 degrees, or pi radians, the terminal side of the angle would intersect the unit circle at the point negative 1, 0. And that's why when we plot the cosine function on the coordinate plane at 180 degrees, cosine is equal to negative 1. And then again at 270 degrees, cosine is equal to 0. And we see that plotted here on the right. And if we reach 360 degrees, or one complete revolution, we end up with the cosine value of what we started with, which is equal to 1. Let me go ahead and animate this so you can just watch it. So again, keep in mind the cosine function is equal to the x-coordinate of the point on the unit circle where the terminal side of the angle intersects the unit circle. And on the right, we're seeing points plotted where the x-coordinate would be the angle, and the y-coordinate would be the cosine of that angle. Remember that this is just showing one revolution around the unit circle. We could make multiple revolutions, so this would go to the right forever and to the left forever, which means our domain would be all reals. And we can also see that the range of the cosine function would be from negative 1 to positive 1. I hope you found this animation helpful.